Describe the development of paper chromatogram. Paper chromatography was first employed by scientist Mikhail Tsvet in 1900. In 1952, A. Martin and R. Synge won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for the development of other chromatographic techniques. In paper chromatography, the paper is most important component. Several types of papers of different shapes, sizes, porosity, and chemically treated are available in the market. Paper is randomly oriented cellulosic fiber. Cellulose is hydrophilic, means solvent loving. Water or other polar solvents are tightly held by cellulose. Development of chromatogram is also known as technique of paper chromatography. We take stripe of paper used for chromatography. The length of the stripe must be 15 cm and breadth about 3.5 cm. At 2 cm from bottom of paper, draw a pencil line. This is called baseline or start line. Small quantity of sample solution is placed at start line. The water present in the solution is dried in air. Now, the sample on paper will appear like pimple or spot on the paper. And this method of putting the sample is known as spotting. Now, this paper is hanged in the jar containing solvent or eluent, which is used for the extraction. It is important that the level of solvent remains below the baseline. When the solvent travels from one end to the other end of the paper, the sample will also travel certain distance on the paper. Later, this paper is removed and dried. Different components of the sample travel different distances. Thus, mixtures are easily separated. This separation process is known as development. The development of the solute from the paper can be done by three different methods. They are ascending development method, descending development method, radial or circular paper method. So let's talk about ascending development method. In ascending paper chromatography, the solvent is placed in trough at the bottom of the jar. The jar is filled with saturated vapor of the solvent. In this case, the end of the paper stripe is immersed in the organic solvent. The solvent rises up due to capillary action. The solvent, when come in contact with the solute or the spot, it will get dissolved in the solvent, forming the solution which is collected at the bottom of the pot. Second, descending development method. When organic solvent is poured from the top to bottom, and while traveling down, it will come in contact with the solute. As the solute is readily soluble in organic solvent, it dissolves, forming solution, which comes down due to gravity and is collected in the pot. The pot is taken out as the solvent is volatile, will vaporize, leaving behind solute, which is analyzed. And the last one is radial or circular paper chromatography method. In this case, the sample is applied to the paper in the form of the spot at the center of the circular paper. Due to the capillary action, it moves radially towards the periphery. For the development, a tank can be easily constructed using two petri dishes placed on one another. This circular paper is stretched between the two faces, and the solvent is applied to the paper at the same point where the sample is applied by making a very small hole with the help of either cotton or wick. If you like this video, please click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel.